To start off with, I'm dealing with the paper one of sociology. Firstly, we'll see what are all the chapters that come underneath it, and what are all the concerning factors that you have besides the chapter what we opt further. So the first chapter that I'm going to preach now is sociology as the discipline. This is the first topic under this static subject. So the concerning factors which will come under this is, first one is the maternity and social changes in Europe and emergence of sociology. So the next one will be the scope of the subject and comparison with other social sciences and sociology and common sense. So these are the three essential ingredients of subclauses which actually come under this sociology as a discipline in the first chapter. These are the three subclauses that you need to work on. So starting with the first we'll see what is sociology is. So this is a subject which is a dead and static subject that you have to memorize a lot and take into account one particular sociological aspect and one particular statement which has actually been articulated by a particular sociologist. So the first thing is, sociology is the science of social life and man and his society. In the sense is, the sociology is a subject which is basically based on the humanities, and basically is a man, how he deals with the society, and the interpretation of how he goes about his society's interference as well. So the turmoil of the changes in these patterns of society and the interrelationships of human beings are important subjects of sociology. As I've told in the second line, the turmoil of the changes in the patterns of the society and the interrelationship of human beings are most important subject of sociology. But underneath, the waves of the sociology wave of changes that lie in the more potent stable of factors which resist the changes. So this is one important aspect where a person should consider himself to be at the center of all the changes, and he should be in a position to accustom and articulate to the corresponding changes as well. He can make sure that he makes use of the scientific aspects as well in these regards. So in general, you know, I would want to articulate sociology as a scientific study of human society and social behavior. There are many sociological thinkers who have actually gone about dealing with these social aspects, but this is a standard definition that I have clubbed it on the whole. So the first topic which I am going to articulate further is the emergence of sociology as a distinct discipline on rationality and scientific temper. So below this, you have to make sure that you divide the parts into context, move, and the body as well. So under this, emergence of sociology as a distinct discipline based on rationality and scientific temper. Rationality is nothing but how you judge a man based upon his qualities, and scientific temper is something like you get accustomed to whatever the situations that you've been dealt with. So context, you know, sociology as a discipline, it was a response to all the social and intellectual happenings that were prevailing in the Europe during the industrial revolution, and the context formation due to the commercial and scientific revolution. That the rational ideas during the Enlightenment period and the ideas of equality, liberty, and fraternity were propagated by the French Revolution as well. So it mainly tells you that how the Industrial Revolution actually took place during mainly the 18th century of wherein which the UK or the England, you know, how they made use of this equality, liberty, and fraternity propagated by the French Revolution. Influenced by those aspects, how these native UKites try to go about this. This is the first aspect. So considering the next point is the move, how we try to understand these aspects with regards to our articulated points. So the first one is, to understand the emergence of sociology in Europe, we need to appreciate the relationship between the society and the ideas. This is the main aspect where you try to link the society with whatever the ideas that they have actually been dealt with. So the first one is the old Europe. See, it was traditional in old Europe, basically. That is what I have put it up over here. Old Europe was traditional
and mainly its economic systems and classes were distinct and clearly. The religion was framed as the main constraint of this society, where the religious had all the authority to control his people and to indicate them so as to what to do and what not to do. He was the main religious head who was responsible for all the functioning of these communities as well. And the king believed that the divinity that ordinated the rule over this people. And the king, as we said, that our Indian aspect or rulity is also based on this patriarchal basis of this UK this system. And it is believed that king is the superior who takes upon the decisions of each and every individual in those local regions as well. So next one is the Enlightenment period in Europe. So it was a intellectual and philosophical movement that dominated the world of ideas in Europe during the 18th century. This is the main happening which is concerned and related to the happenings in the Industrial Revolution of the 18th century of Europe. So Enlightenment, what is Enlightenment? Then you ask me a question about what is Enlightenment is. Enlightenment included a range of ideas. This is the second point. What I am telling you is Enlightenment included a range of ideas and primary source of authority. It also deals with legitimacy and can come into ideas like liberty, progress, tolerance and fraternity. And government and separation of church and state. This is what each and every individual aspect has been fighting for its equal rights in the society and to differentiate a border between the society and the church as well. This paves a lot of innovation and lot of scope as well, so that you won't be injured or imbibed by other rules. So this is what the second point says. The Enlightenment included a range of ideas so that it provides equal amount of liberty, tolerance and fraternity to the constitutional government to differentiate a barrier between the church and the state. Next one is the French Revolution. The French Revolution was actually influenced by the Enlightenment ideas. So these were the main aspects, if you'd ask me. You know, the French they actually dealt a lot with these ideas, you know, to actually go about those instincts and to particularly the concept of popular sovereignty and inalienable rights. Alienable rights is something like you come and acquire as a foreigner, and inalienable rights is something like you can't claim authority from being an outsider as well. So these were some of the aspects which were actually laid down by in those aspects. So the second and third point here is the ideas of the French Revolution coined in the phrases of liberty, equality and fraternity. As said earlier, it is the same as what I discussed in the Enlightenment period in Europe as well. So the two revolutions mainly coincided or included all the aspects of society, social, economic and political agendas as well. So these were the main highlights or the fragments of ingredients. What you have to consider is the two revolutions which I said earlier, that one is the old Europe and the Enlightenment period in Europe. Clubbing or imbibing, including this French Revolution, it included all the three aspects of how to go about these as well. So the two revolutions is just a coincide or it just coincides the main coin terms of both the aspects as well. So the need was felt to study these aspects of the society through a specific discipline, giving birth to sociology. So these are the main fragments, ingredients, which the Industrial Revolution in Europe mainly coincided to form a fraternity and an opinion that society was an imbibed ingredient of all these liberty, fraternity and political agendas taken into account on the whole. So these are the main fragments of this outcome, and these are the main highlights of this agendas.
ಅನ್ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಕೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಇದಾವೆ. ಅನ್ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿ.com ಅಂತ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಐ ದೀಪಕ್ ಚೌಹಾಣ್ ಅಂತ ನೀವು ಸರ್ಚ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೋರ್ಸಸ್ಸು ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡೈಲಿ ನಾನು ಹಿಂದೂ ಎಡಿಟೋರಿಯಲ್ನ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀನಿ, ಮತ್ತು ಡೈಲಿ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಫೇರ್ಸು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀನಿ. ಅದೇ ಥರ MCQs ಎಕನಾಮಿ ಮೇಲೆ MCQs ಮತ್ತು ಪಾಲಿಟಿ ಮೇಲೆ MCQs ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಫೇರ್ಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ MCQs ಕೂಡ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀನಿ. ಸೊ ನೀವು ಈ ವಿಡಿಯೋನು ನೋಡ್ಕೋಬೋದು. ಈ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ನ ನೋಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಕಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಸ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಡ್ಬೋದು, ಫೈವ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಸ್ ರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಡ್ಬೋದು ನಿಮಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟ ಆದರೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಐದಿಪಕ್ ಜೋನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನೀವು ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಈ ಕೋರ್ಸಸ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ವೀಡಿಯೋ ಹಾಕಿದ್ರು ಕೂಡ ನಿಮಗೆ ತಕ್ಷಣ ನೋಟಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ಬಂದುಬಿಟ್ಟಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ನೀವು ಅವಾಗಲೇ ಆ ವೀಡಿಯೋನ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ಬೋದು.